and shorts, and surf, and scuba, and sand, and sailing, and soccer. San Diego, California.
Season's greetings and welcome to a brand new episode of Two Balls and a Mic, San Diego's number one soccer outlet, soccer podcast, powered by San Diego Punto Football. That is the hub of everything soccer in San Diego. You can find the latest news, nothing but truth and coverage of what we do with the integrity that the soccer community deserves for its coverage in San Diego. We're going to go ahead and get this started today. We're going to go ahead and have ourselves a little discussion about a little match that we had last night. San Diego Soccer's move on to the semifinals of the Western Conference Finals. But the most important game happened at halftime. We're going to go ahead and do a full game breakdown. Chiva versus Tony, the third iteration. Will Tony be victorious and undefeated at Pechanga Arena, or did Chiva finally get his glory back? Spoiler! We're going to have the call of the sirens a little bit later on. Going to be joined to hear what they've been going on. Inspector sirens happening. Yep. Some banners, but some positive news as well. We're going to go ahead and get into all of that new show for the sirens as well. We're going to also dive into SD Wave upcoming game against Louisville. It's a Corniak revenge game. It's going to get set up for that exactly. It's going to be fun to talk about. And some She Believes action. Jaden Shaw getting involved. Kalen Sheridan came in at a couple of minutes ago as well. SDFC, the MLS, has announced a Chula Vista Chrome Ball Tour, and they are going balls against the wall. Chrome balls, that is. All respect.
Yeah, go ahead.
Chula Vista is going to be popping. Lil Rob, National City's own Lil Rob, will be representing
I think they put South Bay Zone, right?
South Bay Zone. South Bay Zone. Just letting everybody know when he was riding down. Marco Invartsen also scored, the person that we got right for being San Diego FC's second signing. Mm-hmm. We may touch on a little controversial thing that we kind of got involved with. One David Feitelson claiming to have insider information about Hugo Sanchez being San Diego FC's first ever head coach.
Cap.
We'll see.
Cap.
Or nap time. It is definitely nap time for David Feitelson.
That's a cool segment. Cap or nap time.
Sure. All right.
It doesn't make sense.
It does not make any sense. El Juego Bonito, goals, gaffes, and greats of the week. And, I mean, how are you, Chiva?
I'm good. I'm a little upset.
You're a little bit upset.
Yeah. I left that arena very upset.
Your jimmies were rustled.
Yeah.
Okay. So yesterday. Hold on. Let's set it up.
Tee me up.
Welcome, everybody, who's watching on Instagram, Twitch, and on YouTube on the live stream. Usually, it's going to go back now to every Monday at 8. Obviously, we had stuff to do. Look at that riesgo.
No, the comentario que puso 619 Soccer. I don't know if he means if I would have lost another time.
I don't speak millennial. What does that mean? ID space KMS.
I don't know if I want to say it out loud.
I'd kind of smash? All right, cool.
Kind of smash. myself.
All right. Right. Hey, it's still a garage, as proven if you were tuning into Soccer's Overtime. But all right, so there was season's greetings to the champion, correctly on the right side of history, Eric Fowler.
Cheater.
Well, okay, we'll get into that. So San Diego Soccer yesterday had a playoff match to see who was going to move into the semifinals of the Western Conference Finals with Chihuahua in way. If they won, they would have a rematch of everything that happened last year with them. And it's literally WrestleMania. It's Cody Rhodes versus Roman Reigns again. Can San Diego FC finish the story? And
San Diego Soccer's
finished the story and, take on the big bad in Chihuahua for what they did to them last year. It's a really cool story. It's going to happen. But yeah, so that's why there wasn't any, you know, any episode yesterday. Moving into today, so we're all going to have the Sirens rescheduled for that for today. And so, I mean, you didn't seem... I was being nice to you this whole time. This whole week leading up to it. I'm like, hey, man, you're going to score on me. Like,
no,
I think this is it.
No.
This is it.
I told you.
This is it.
Oh,
this is
you
the year.
Son of a bitch. I know exactly where you're going with this. And I called it out before. You're only saying this. Tony told me before the game, it's okay. You're going to score on me. You're going to, like, you're not going to win, but you're going to score on me, and mm-hmm. that's okay.
Yeah,
I'm not even going to get to warm up, and that's what you're going to
score. I didn't.
And I told you, you know what? You're using this as an excuse already in case it happens. You're okay with it. But in the case that you do win and I don't score on you, you're going to use this against me and say, I didn't get to warm up. I didn't get to do this. And I still won and you didn't score on me. That's the only reasons you were throwing those excuses. You weren't being nice. You were only using it for yourself.
Other than the fact that you're saying that these were excuses, none of what you said is false. I did not have an opportunity, excuse me, to warm up. As obviously, I had to be on the call with Craig Elston. Brian Farber, number 7, legendary San Diego Soccer, came in and stepped in for commentary as I made my way down there. You had all the time in the world to warm up with your team, talk tactics. Let me tell you what I did. I came into the arena with my, you know, regular just get up.
You also had 2 people that knew how to kick the ball.
Excuse me. Let's not get ahead of ourselves. I know you're trying to end the pain.
That's all I'm saying.
But I get to the arena. There's a catering and everything. So we wolf some. I'm down. And a teammate of mine got there and in the form of Johnny Richardson, Everything San Diego. Shout out to Johnny. Great content, does a lot of Padre stuff, a lot of soccer stuff as well. Check him out. But he got there, and immediately as I saw him, the first thing I told him is like, hey, Johnny, you're on defense. Start tactics. I don't like you have no choice. Eric Fowler, my other teammate.
Johnny did not listen to you.
Hey. He was there when I needed him to, all right? He did his job, and he became a little bit of a maverick going, we're going to break down the entire game. So we'll get to that here in a bit, but with commentary, thank you, Craig and Farber, for staying on halftime, and the great people over at TVX who are broadcast streaming platform and crew who do a great job there at the arena. Check them out, TVX. But essentially, it came down to you had time to prepare. You had all the time in the world. Could have gotten there an hour before, done some stretches. I don't know what you did to prepare. Did you do anything to prepare? What did you do? You got to
pass the ball.
Or you were like,
so I got to the arena and I went to the seats where my girl sat. And I sat with her during the whole first quarter and part of the second quarter. Then I headed downstairs to change and, you know, just kick the ball around a little bit and whatnot. And that was it. It's not like I had a whole hour and a half to prepare either. I literally went like 15 minutes before we had to jump on the field.
All right. So with that, we'll get to some of the highlights of this, obviously. But I will recommend that small children be removed from the viewing platform at this time because we're going to, you know, as we talk about the game that actually happened and the excuse making, you know, some of the images that captured by the great at Young the Ryan, our pal, friend, you know him, you love him. Helped break the SDFC dream for it to be. It's fine. It's a mosquito. You'll be fine. You'll be great. You know, those don't actually give you like granos and stuff. They don't. Anyway. All right. So let me just find that right here. Your discretion is advised. Some of these images are not apt for children. But it was a good time. Beto, DJ Beto, you know, he's a world traveler with his music and on-air talents. Emor Villa on my team. I had the dark blue team. You had the white team. Second year, you choose that. Last year with the USA. This time, that one. All right, cool.
I didn't choose the
color. Moving on, you know, as we see this very, very tightly fitted green jersey. It was incredibly humbling. Looking over some of these images,
Wait, go back.
What?
That looks just like this.
I hate that you have access to do these things now.
That looks just like this.
I like what, boy? Let's go, boy. Oh, you took over. Oh, yeah. No, I see it. Look. And one and two.
Boom.
And one and two. Talk about the Big Green. Great soccer movie. But yeah, so you had Tom. What is Tom? Wait, you didn't even know the players on your team. You want to know something that I found out through sources? I found this out through sources, and you're going to be very happy with this. And we're having some people trickle in here because we want to make sure that everybody gets the joy of the call as well. My sources have confirmed with me that your goalkeeper, the only person that scored against me yesterday, best MVP automatically, said to a certain somebody, hey, if we're going to do this next year, you got to put some players in front of me. The goalkeeper, BJ McPherson. Yeah,
no, that motherfucker talks so much shit, saying all these different things like, oh, let's get these cocksuckers and this and this and this
cock
and everything.
Cocksuckers, like, heck yeah.
You like how he said it, right?
Yeah.
That dude was talking so much shit for someone that can hardly fucking move.
Oh my God, he's a legendary goalkeeper for the San Diego
old
Bulls.
Old ass dude, you can't have freaking some respect. Move, can't use his hand, bring some gloves. You're going to be a goalkeeper, BJ. Bring some gloves next time.
He doesn't roll that way. You know what?
Then,
maybe next year?
No.
Can maybe get him
I would have been a
involved.
Way better goalkeeper.
Have him be a little bit
I
more
I would
involved.
Have been a better goalkeeper.
Have him be
Craig,
a little
next
bit
time,
more.
Do not get him as a goalkeeper. Get me someone else or put me in Tony's team. Can't beat him, join him.
It's the media game where Team Blue is ahead of Team White.
If you can't beat him, join him. Some of the video package highlights, thank you, courtesy of TVX. I mean, new arena, new outcomes. I don't know. Don't work yourself into a shoot, brother.
There you go. Esteban is media. Esteban could be my goalkeeper.
Hey,
granted.
Next year, Craig, I put the boy on the map. I tried, but you
know
what?
Also bring in Brandon. Brandon's also a content creator.
Relax.
Bring him in.
Hey, you don't even work for the team, so relax.
okay, doing that. That's fine.
You can't be calling the shots here. No, 100%. New arena, new players. I'd love that. Esteban, I think. That's a great idea that I actually came up with last time because I did pitch it to Soccer's to have you and Brandon come up. But again, I don't make those decisions, which is A-okay because it still made up for a fantastic, fantastic time out there.
It was fun.
It was fun. It's always a blast out there. But all right, it's not this one because that's later. The goals, gaffes, and greats, everybody's favorite segment, El Juego Bonito, coming on back. But again, thank you to our partners over at TVX.
We're back. It's halftime. Match two of the Ron Newman Cup Division semifinals, where it is 3-1 Soccer's here. It's
some of
the media
action.
Game where Team Blue is ahead of...
All right, stop it right there. We're going to talk through this a little bit, talk and walk everybody through. At this point, it's already 1-0.
I don't know why David made that little 360 turn, but it looked freaking sick.
He did, yeah, 100%.
It's like, where's the ball? Oh, there you are. Boom.
Honestly, I was impressed by somebody who was wearing not... optimal soccer footwear.
Yeah.
With his skill. I was thoroughly impressed by a lot of people. I'm not gonna lie. I didn't know what was gonna come out of some of these plays. Literally, I can't talk because like even though I might have a
wait, no te pegaste en el board?
Man, those
did you hit your head
pores,
or anything?
I was not tech for a concussion. But yeah, at this point, I already had an assist on the log. It's already 1-0 here when they picked it up because they had to go to commercial. Yeah. Assist for me, media game, excellent.
We're back. It's halftime.
Okay.
Match two of the
good little
Cup
pass.
Division
good
semifinals.
Move. I got scared at this point.
3-1
a little 360.
It's
all
the
right.
Media game where Team Blue is ahead of Team White.
Shot off.
And Tony Sanchez
right there.
Is diving down to
dive,
protect. His near post.
And yes, I hit myself. Yeah, and I thought it worked once. I'm going to do
Jeff,
it again. Cabana Boy Jeff.
Shoots
almost.
It wide. As BJ McPherson challenging
why
him.
Is the goalkeeper? The why is BJ going out like that?
Because who else is? I'm going to defend BJ. All right.
No, but there's some two defenders there already.
Are
okay,
they?
Granted, Scott Lewis should have stepped up and then BJ can back down.
Scott Lewis, CEO of Voice of San Diego.
It's legend. He would prefer for the ice.
Defensa. La roba bien. La tengo. Boom. Vámonos.
My podcast itinerant.
Good block there.
Superstar.
This is so unnecessary. No, wait, wait, go back. Go
save
back.
Of the Can, game.
No, I know. Go back. Go
you
back.
Know what?
Before that, though, Mr. Eric Fowler, why were you eating so much grass? You were eating the turf? Like Casper was tackling you or something? Look. Look, there's Eric cast, Fowler right there in the bottom corner. Boom. Casper. HJ.
I'm so sorry, Eric. I'm so sorry.
Nah, we were joking about it after
sent
the game.
He sent me a picture of his knees after. You were saying, after this match...
Everyone was fucking beat up. Everyone was beat up. Their knees were scraped, turf burn here and there. I was like, guys, we played for 8 minutes. I didn't eat it. Trust me, I've eaten shit before there, but...
The sniper got him. Shout out Eric Fowler.
Everyone's been a good sport, though. Everyone had fun. Everyone kept saying, you know what? That was fun. 6-on-6. That shit's hard. It's a lot of running.
Save of the match. Play. Boop. Borderline play of the match.
Where
is it? Let's relive everything.
Honestly, there, I should have kept running more with the ball up, but I don't trust my superstar dribbling skills as much.
Safety.
Oh, este güey. La pateaste este, vale madre. You're like, get this shit out of here.
Yeah, more
trying to clear with the headers. Wait, no puede correr, BJ. BJ can hardly run.
But he cleared it.
Good pass.
Oh, and a great stop by Amor Villa.
Amor Villa, part of the Philip Rivers Academy of Running.
Boom, Sarapongo. David goes back.
Patient.
For the pass. Looking
patient.
For the pass.
Smart.
I think we're all yelling at him like, hey, you got three. You got three or
you
something.
You guys are 4-3. I mean, this is a power play situation in,
but
in these
quick.
Terms.
Amor is very quick, so I think he got there too.
So, yes.
Gets the block off.
Gets the block.
I think you told him, like, sakala.
I was yelling at people, and I forgot to tell Johnny and others, like, when I'm out there and I yell at you, don't take it personal. Please don't, because I'm in a different dimension mentally. I'm just locked and loaded. Like, I yelled to a couple of my teammates. So, you know, thank you for responding
like the
perfectly.
That's down the
good
street,
clearance.
He's gonna throw it over a fence.
He wanted here's to. Scott's like, okay, I'm going to pass it back. Come on. Boy, Jeff with the pressure.
A great clearance by BJ McPherson.
I'm trying my best to run up and down this freaking field. I'm trying out here.
You did run the most out of anybody.
Thank you. Thank you. Scott runs up. I'm on goal at this point. I'm like, okay, go out there, King. Do your shit. Like, go off. I'll stay and guard the goal. I would have used my hands.
There was no referee.
Yeah, no ref. I
clearly, other people use their hands and nothing happened, so why not?
That was when Sal Zizo happened to
bring
her his way into the game.
Takes a shot off the board. Okay, BJ still not really doing much. Oh, Johnny Este compa, he came in as a sub because AJ Preller didn't show up.
Off of the left post.
HJ.
HJ. On a brace.
Whatever.
And then a good save by
good
BJ
save.
With his feet.
So far, MVP performance by BJ McPherson.
Okay.
On your team? Absolutely.
Frankie V had to tie his shoes.
Frankie V with a great turn, just destroying Beto here. I mean, radio on radio violence is always condoned. keeping it clean a little bit here. A little bit of a bump, but where was Shiva? Shiva should have been there to recover that ball.
Bato, estoy ira, la robé. I'm like, Frankie, boom, pónmela. Pónmela.
Eric, just screaming
another
to the heavens in pain.
Casper, again.
What a step up by Amor. What a step up by Amor.
Tony, you know if that pass goes through, that's a great chance.
By the way, this is the magic of watching on YouTube. So shout out to everybody who watches on YouTube on this live stream. If you want to catch exactly what's going on, we'll make a short version of this just so it's palatable in that way.
Dude,
so.
I told Frankie, dude, honestly, you're probably the most fit in this arena, in this game. You're going to have to do most of the running.
He did.
He did a lot of the running.
4 or 3.5 minutes left.
But I think I needed him to tie his shoe a little
Fowler.
Tighter. But yeah, Kina Rawai. That was a good steal.
Knocked down Frankie V. We
were two time open on the left. Gave a good chance.
Just coming down the floor.
Pass it, and I mean, La Roba Amor has all the space in the world. Bicicleta. Johnny had the chance of his lifetime.
Johnny.
Did you see the little? He went like this.
Johnny.
Really almost had it.
I was rooting for him so hard.
Another
get
one.
Johnny. Don't get Johnny.
My boy Jeff. What's my goalkeeper doing?
Lethal. Lethal.
What is
lethal.
My goalkeeper doing?
Excellent.
You guard,
Cabana
you cover
boy.
Your first post.
Cabana
you
boy.
You cover your first
you
post.
You are a a legend. Look at this. No business does he have shooting this. Scott Lewis is on top of it. He's got it locked. And then BJ covering the second post because he knows his defender is going to go ahead and cover that 1,000% of the time. But the skill to get it on the near post for two
you
plays.
Can't even hold your last eight. Yet. Score! You can't even hold in your last. The amount of boys, Jeff, is a
brace.
He's a
That's
freaking
two.
Beast.
Man, when the pipe broke in Sports Arena and postponed this match to begin with, I was elated because Cabana Boy wasn't going to make it. He was busy with other things, and he's back. Here, I don't know what you're doing. What's going on?
I told Frankie, make the run. All of our teams are. I'm like, let's clear it to this side. If I pass it back, they're going to kick it, give it to the other team too. So
it,
here I'm telling Frankie, reset. Make the run. It wasn't the best pass either. So.
It's a reset now in the middle of the
I'm going to shoot it, and you wave to me. No, you can't do that.
No.
Oh, I thought, you can't do it. I was like, Mr. Rules over here.
I didn't sell you. You couldn't do that.
You went like this.
I did go like this. I did like this because I'm like, don't even try it.
Oh, okay.
Like, don't
I
even
thought you meant
think,
it like,
no,
you can't do that. I'm like, okay, Mr. Rules
over
here.
You can do
whatever
you want.
Mr. I work for the soccer. I'm going to follow the rules in the game.
Yeah, I would probably get suspended
two
from the
balls.
Actual soccers for saying that. That's just the league would come out after
two
me.
Handballs.
I was just saying, don't even try it. Like, it please don't embarrass yourself. But yeah, so you give this pass to absolutely no one. I come out. I'm like, I'll have some fun with this.
Tony, trying to keep the all-time clean sheet. That's what he wants.
That is what I wanted, but no. I think that. And it wasn't on the TVX highlight package, but I just want to highlight myself. Not that I ever want to do that.
Oh, no.
What's up, Cabana Boy? He's a stout legend. So it went unrecognized, but this play here, I have everything under control. I point to Frankie. I'm like, stop. You don't want to come here. I'm going to pick it up. I try to pick it up to fake it. Frankie doesn't go for it. I'm like, I got to go for a different resource.
Yeah, and then you foul Frankie.
And he fouled me.
No,
he's fouling me right there.
You foul him.
He's fouling me right there.
You foul him.
How? Where?
You foul him. Look at that. You tripped him up. You tripped him up.
I did not trip anybody up.
You fouled him. That should have been a foul.
And then just excellent, just class.
I mean,
the little three sticks
he's been. You guys are out here fouling. Using hands.
Never been beaten here. However, I do have to make a correction on the fantabulous, legendary maverick of an announcer. Just the guy. He's so good at what he does. Craig. I've been scored on before. Once. He who shall not be named in the game against Shannon McMillan. Shannon McMillan didn't score on me, but I was scored on.
Was it Jake?
In that match. No, it wasn't Jake Ariani. I refuse. It's
the goals guy.
That's as far as we're going to get. Yeah. I still wear that. I still remember just how it went down.
Yeah, they did.
But yes, minor stat correction. It's fine. Chiba here trying. I don't know.
Dude, I'm gassed. I'm like, fuck, I got to run. Do you see my reaction? I'm like, fuck, I got to keep running. No, I'm in.
Amor tripping on Casper. He was the dirtiest player in the game. Good move.
He is showing some skill. Amor.
Boom. Mano de Amor. Handball.
Callously shoots save. Looking for the hat trick.
Handball.
He's got his second.
Amor had a handball there.
So you're saying that in that play that
it hit off his hand.
Oh, looks good. He's got it.
Let's see. Amor is, so you're saying this happens. Amor is dribbling off the left side, takes cross.
Like you said, sombrerito, era?
Just clear it. Boom. I would have been so mad at you.
Handball.
That doesn't look like a handball to me.
It hit his arm.
There's no footage. I don't believe you.
It hit his arm. Hit his arm. So
able to come back. Gret, stop. Again, the most important player that's intervened in your team is BJ McPherson.
Callously shoot save
and just with the left, just that la pata bendita, like
media game hat trick.
It's impressive. Craig Elston said last time he got a hat trick because Sal Zizzo was there. I say no, It's because Cabana Boy Jeff is out there.
Need to get some goals for the white team.
Stu flying out.
Stu went flying.
Frankie.
Frankie V losing a shoe for the first time. There will be one more. BJ McPherson, ¿qué estás haciendo? Just commanding the defensive line. The ball exits the Pelea field. Nobody listens to it. Eric Fowler continues.
Handball again.
Where? You tell me where.
Fowler.
Where?
He hit it with his arm. What do you mean?
I don't believe you.
Oh, my God.
Let's see. Let's see.
It caught it on camera.
All right. So ball exits. Okay, cool. Already an erroneous play to begin with.
This game has been...
Yeah.
Okay.
No. Yeah.
Skill.
Yeah.
He's going to go ahead and absolutely dispose of Scott Lewis.
It can always be fine.
Ah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Just the control. Honestly, if these 2 milliseconds of footage are just everything that exists of Eric Fowler's tape, you'd think, oh, he's the greatest player on earth. Just the body composure, everything's like kind of like Giroux.
And then he hits it with his elbow and arm. Boom. That goal should have not counted. Beto, not to discourage your shot or anything, but that goal should have not counted. That's all I'm saying.
Fowler just throws the elbow and bumps.
¿Qué está haciendo mi portero, güey? Dime, oh, sí, portero crack.
What an assist. 4-1. Announcer.
4-0.
Are on it. 4-0. They count it. Everybody's high-fiving.
Emo's laughing. He told me that one should have counted.
Chivas pissed. Chivas upset here.
Yeah. I'm like,
Cameron doesn't catch it, but I'm laughing.
So tired.
I'm laughing.
I'm like, I'm like,
kicks it over there.
I'm like, fuck it, I'm just gonna shoot it.
You shoot it.
Blue abuelo, a la Azteca.
I get it. This is again. I need to provide a show for the people because again, price of admission of itself. Sure, you get 2 soccer games, but you get to watch Cabana Boy Jeff play.
Yeah, 100%.
But I don't know. People still need a little bit more. Like, what else can I do? Cabana Boy's done his job. He's now in defense. I'm like, hey, Jeff, come over here. Because I wanted him to turn around so I could throw it to his back and just play it out. But, like, that didn't really translate. So he just kind of comes back. He's like, hey, what's up? He's like, yeah, oh, here.
Just pass it back to me.
He wasn't waiting for it, but he reacted well. He's like, okay, cool.
Oh, I love it. Oh, but no.
My favorite. That was literally... Pass. Literally my favorite thing.
Which was a bad
that
pass.
I have no, it wasn't, went directly to Eric.
No, it went to the wall.
Well, we used the walls in indoor soccer, Chiba.
Yeah, but it's a pass.
It could potentially potentially been a wall scorer. It could have been.
You should have known that I was on him right there. You should have.
It could have been a potential for a great wall scorer assist.
Not passed to him. That was a terrible pass, Tony.
A second assist. Yeah, let's watch this shot again.
Team Blue is killing it.
Who shot that? Oh, okay. Okay, cool. Skill, mentality, cool. Point to the right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was still a bad pass.
Look at those jelly rolls. Jeez.
Love it.
Terrible pass because you know he has someone.
No, I don't. Where are you? You're not even in frame.
Play it.
You're not even in frame.
Okay, play it. I'm right there.
Oh, you're coming right in closing.
Keep playing
with your,
it.
With
keep
your
playing
speed.
It, Tony. Don't just stop and talk.
Pass through Frankie V.
Wait, in the same way that you were being critical about David Frecker's
Yeah, I will. Control. Look, this is where I'm going to be critical. Keep playing it.
I won't, and I will elevate my teammates.
It was that
saying,
play that led to our goal.
It.
Your bad pass led to our goal.
That was
look,
a, that was a good,
it,
that was
Tony.
A good. That was a good pass.
Mequito el Fowler.
You foul him.
No, I don't.
Pull,
that's not
pull,
a foul.
Pull
I'm
a
running.
Member of the armed
I'm running
service.
Forward.
Who do you think you
I'm
are?
I'm running forward.
Who are you?
I'm running
I'm
forward.
I'm submitting
there.
This to the no. armed service
oh,
police
send it.
Right now.
Vale.
All right? You Madre. Are assaulting a member of the defender of the defender of the Constitution.
I don't care if he was the president.
I'd do that. Chiba, here
on
we go.
On a silver platter, David.
Let's just
David.
Note, let's
David.
Just note.
David, I'm looking right here. David.
It's 5-2.
David. And we scored in this play.
See what? Because it's 5-2.
David. I gave it to you there, man. You told me before the game you were going to body check Tony. Play it, Tony.
He actually told that to a couple people.
He sets up Frecker. Frecker's got the look. And Tony with a slide tackle. And then the shot's wide.
I'm disappointed of the shot.
That was yours. That was it.
But I'm gassed, Tony. I'm tired.
And then...
In your mind, you're like, hell yeah, all this shit, I'm going to talk to Chiba because you scored and he did it and we're still winning. All this saying like, yep, I'm going to call him the best player in the team.
And this game is about
scores as I pull my pants up. BJ McPherson. Amazing. All right, a couple things in this play. This is the most breakdown we've ever done since Loyal.
Giant arena now.
Okay, so let's relive this. Cool. So, okay, the play happens. You dispose of him. Eric Fowler. All right, he's fought as much as he can. Frecker right there. Great touch.
That's not a great touch.
I'm just too quick off my line.
Shut the fuck up.
Great
dude.
Touch by
that's
David.
That's not a great touch.
David,
le adelantó mucho.
Don't let this man
no,
bring you down.
No, it's okay. It's okay.
You showcase skill. You showcase composure.
The touches went a little too far. It's
I
okay.
was just better.
No, you came
yesterday.
Out good. You
I just,
came out good.
100%.
You came
you
out good. Yes.
That. It could have been a better pass.
But
he was ready.
Yes, it could have been a better
he
pass.
He was ready
yes.
for a header. How do you know? He wanted it here. He told Brian Farber that he was going to do a bicycle kick. And you took that away from him.
Oh, you should have. You didn't tell me that.
You should have known that. You should have known that he is an aerial player.
You know what?
David is an aerial player.
Brown pass would have been easier. He's right there.
So in this split second decision, I could have come down and scooped it with my hands. But because of the dexterity, and I don't know if he knows how to fall, I don't want to hurt anybody. I just decided to slide tackle with my legs instead of just sweeping him out of it. Unfortunately, still kind of end up on the floor. Good rebound shot. Chiba here. The glory. I'm set. Like, this is the most engaged I am in the entire game because I was not going to let you score off of this shot. On my life. That's why I didn't care about anything else because I knew you weren't going to get the ball back. And that's all I cared for you not to score. I knew the game was in the bag.
Chiba looking for more. Oh. And it's kicked away by Johnny.
Good idea. You were gassed. And then the touch of an angel.
Oh my
the gosh, touch of an angel. BJ yeah. McPherson, the best player on your team.
Sure.
When I looked up and I saw red, and I'm like I it's that split second, I'm like,
honestly, BJ McPherson, greatest goalkeeper to play in a media game.
You
he's
know
the
what?
Only goalkeeper to ever score. Better than you.
Uh-huh.
Better than any other goalkeeper uh-huh. that we've had.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. I agree.
But how many W's does he have?
I agree. Doesn't matter.
No,
he
no,
has a goal.
Mine is backed up by stats.
When's the last time you scored?
Mine's backed up by
oh,
stats.
Oh, man, ladies and gentlemen.
In a losing
BJ
effort?
McPherson, congratulations.
In
you
a,
are the best goalkeeper that Pechanga Arena has had in a media halftime game. Better than Tony Sanchez.
In
better than the greats. You are the only one to score. In a media game, yes. Only goalkeeper to score. I agree with you, Tony. That
he was
man
the best player
a legend.
On your team.
That man was the best player
on your team
in the game. Goalkeeper scoring a goal. Goalkeeper scoring a goal. Greatest goalkeeper performance the Changa Arena has seen in a media game. Wow. The greatest goalkeeper performance is BJ McPherson. It's not Tony Sanchez. There we go, ladies and gentlemen.
I agree
with you.
I agree with you. I could admit that. One of the greatest
yeah.
performances.
Greatest goalkeeper we've had.
In a losing
ever.
Effort.
Greatest goalkeeper we've ever had.
This
wow.
is a 3-0 versus a 0-3 situation.
That's okay.
That's
when's
okay.
the last time you scored a goal?
When was the last time you beat me?
When's the last time you scored a goal?
When was the last time you beat
that,
me?
My goalkeeper scored a goal.
I gave
I
him
I am
flowers.
Very proud of you.
I gave him
un gol
flowers.
De portero, we all know. You're... When a goalkeeper scores, it counts like 5. We technically
oh, does
won
it?
That game.
Oh, does it?
We technically won that game. Our goalkeeper scored.
Okay.
Man, you... I'm sorry to the team and the other team.
Congratulations
team.
On
you guys
your victory.
Deserve the better goalkeeper.
Congratulations on your victory.
Thank you. I appreciate it. I'm not shaking your
see,
hand.
It would have been yours.
The last
you had
I
it.
Washed those hands.
All I'll say that as I summoned that. Last thing on this is thank you again, San Diego Soccers, for allowing us to make a ridiculous effort of soccer, the mockery of
appreciate
the sport.
It.
Some great. Soccer actually happened there. Check out the San Diego Soccer's coming up April 21st at home. They will need everybody out there.
I'm also just going to say this. Craig, I love you. But I think in the last, at least the first one that we participated and this one, you gave the preferable players to Tony. You gave South Sisters to Tony's
mean?
Team. You gave them different players in this. I mean.
Great action shots here by... at Young the Ryan. Just again, look at the speed of Johnny. Just those power legs. He's been working on it.
Yeah.
He's been working
on it.
He's gone there. It left Sonny speechless.
Yeah.
Like, oh my God, is that Johnny?
Johnny Richardson.
Action shot here for Chiva. Trying to do it all. Beto laughing at you in the background. Like, what is he going to try to do? Score?
That's exactly what he was doing.
Score. Some of these action shots are... they don't do justice for how bad all of us looked out there.
Yeah.
100%. 100%. Look at that.
Tres dedos.
Wow. Eric Fowler again, $1 million.
I'm surprised Ryan got Eric Fowler on his feet.
Honestly, I'm pretty convinced he didn't. He just edited that very well. I like this picture of your face. Hello.
La cara de Lemor, güey. Me pica la bola.
Sean Bowers in the back, just electrified.
He's like, sign this
he's
guy.
Looking at Cabana Boy Jeff,
he's like dude, I've we gotta huge, sign him.
I've made a huge mistake.
No, he's like, we gotta sign Cabana Boy Jeff to the Sounders.
Melissa May in the back had some money on Team White.
These motherfuckers suck.
Just going through a couple of these again. Great shots at Young the Ryan. That's gonna be linchpincreativephoto.com. Check it out. A lot of his catalog is neatly and as organized directly from the artist and directly from the creator himself, at Young the Ryan Young. Thank you. And he captured my favorite moment once again. So Frankie V, tenacious, coming in. Me, a helpless little gazelle on the prairie.
A gazelle.
Oh,
no, look.
What's that? Is that a lion over there? Frankie already stepping over to his left.
I'm glad your favorite play is the one play that led to our goal.
I mean, it wasn't my mistake. It was your foul. You fouled. Yeah, some of these are not charming, but nonetheless, here they are. Chiva with that. Looks like you're taking a good shot, but Johnny's Richardson scared you off. Cabana Boy Jeff, again, getting it done. Top to bottom, MVP. And again, it was all fun and games, smiles everywhere. You're heavier than you used to be. I'm heavier than I used to be. Good smiles all around. Great time out there. Great time out there. I really appreciate everybody who came out and supporting, cheering. I was actually asked for my jersey after.
¿No te las diste?
No.
That's best. Why did you give it to them?
Because I just looked over and I said, nope. I can't because this is my only shirt.
That is messed up. Like,
wait, la única que me queda.
You had to take it off in front of
the entire that entire dad son combo could have fit neatly inside my one jersey. So
yeah,
you know, maybe next time. But
thank you, San Diego Soccer, for inviting us. I think this is a good segue to our next segment.
Absolutely. As we have the Call of Sirens is coming up because we do have a bi-weekly check-in with the supporters, official supporter group of the San Diego Wave, who had, you know, since last time we spoke, had another home match, Blazer night. That was a tremendous success.
Yeah.
Some other things did happen and occur after that match, including some banners, and I might see if I can kind of see if on the lighter side of things on their perspective on that, and then also, you know, talk about things that are coming, watch parties and whatnot. And so without further ado, we're gonna go ahead and go into the Call of the Sirens, and we are here with Tanya once again. Tanya, how are you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. Just came back from the watch party. For the She Believes Cup.
That's awesome. How was the atmosphere out there? It's always good. San Diego supports U.S. Women's National Team soccer in general, but
yeah,
they really come out.
I mean, it was good. It's tough to watch this wave on wave crime.
Yeah.
With Jake and Alex scoring on Kaylin, but it was good overall.
You know, not gonna lie, part of me was like, okay, come on, Canada, win the penalty shootout. Kaylin deserves this. Come on. It's the She Believes Cup. It's not the Gold Cup. I was like, oh, come on, poor Kaylin.
Somewhere.
Honestly, same.
Yeah,
I was kind of rooting for Caitlyn.
She needs one.
Yeah, she deserves one.
Come on. Maybe there's a potential change in citizenship.
I mean, just seeing her celebrate how when they won the Shield, you're like, man, she deserves something with Canada. Come on.
And when she wins, Craig Elston, the PA announcer for the San Diego Wave games over at Snapdragon, is going to be walking his dog or something. And Sharon is going to make a stop, and he's just going to just like, Caitlyn, Sheridan.
Yeah.
Love that. But yeah, I mean, so just kind of since last time we spoke, you know, it was right before Blazer Night. That was a success overall. Everybody enjoyed it.
A bit of feedback. Just then letting us in the comments, Tony.
Okay. Yeah, it's probably the back and forth. But yeah, we have it recorded. We're going to go ahead and upload this with better audio. But how was the... how was the Blazer Night for you guys and everything that kind of went down on that positive side?
Oh, it was great. The tailgate was full of people in Blazers. It was just awesome to see everyone. We had little babies in Blazers. It was awesome.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, we saw a great picture with actually president of the San Diego. The locals, president of the, I guess, the Milk Club or something like that, with Caitlyn, with Casey Stoney, and just the face that Casey Stoney made of just like, oh, just surprise. Yeah. That's a total mom face. And that's just knowing what it's like. But after the celebrations, defeating Rain, finally, Seattle, great match. There was some news that came down. Actually, we heard directly from the club, and as they were heading into the room to look at the cameras, that some banners had been gone missing. Fortunately, good story, they were returned intact. San Diego really came out and supported the Sirens in that way. So, just from your guys' perspective, like how was that just before getting them returned, and moving on after, is there any sort of official posts to now have people, you know, on guard for that?
I don't know if we have an official post. We might after that. But yeah, everything, I mean, we were on a high, you know, and then we kind of found that out. It kind of bummed us out a little bit. But I sent out that tweet and I did not think that it was going to spread like wildfire like it did. It was being reposted, shared, retweeted. It was insane to see the amount of support that the Sirens and the Wave actually have. And then to wake up the next day and see that people like Shannon was offering to replace them. Alex was asking to get returned. So it was just amazing to see. And we did get them back the next day. And I went to go pick them up myself. Honestly, like I was super emotional driving to go get them. And once I had them in my hand, it was just like such a relief. Because there's a lot of time, effort, money that goes into these things. It's a personal connection to artwork. So it's a big part of the code. So I'm glad they returned
them. Yeah, because I'm assuming you don't expect that, right? You don't expect someone would just take the banners, take anything like that. I mean, it's one of the first times I hear that happens in a game.
Yeah, it's definitely not something that we expected to happen.
Yeah, and again, just testament to the soccer community and everything that the Sirens mean and how important they are, because I did see that there was a big, large mobilization. And, you know, as soon as we heard, we're like, yeah, no, like, they, guys, whoever has it, like, they have cameras on you. So just do the right thing. And I think the right thing was done. I'm very glad that they were returned intact and happy ending here, fortunately. And again, it's a lot of hard work that goes into them, resources in general. It's not about the actual artifact itself. It's just what it stands for and what it means. And you know, it's what's made Snapdragon home for the Cove and the Wave, because that's what it is. It's a giant family, and I really like the interconnectedness that is clearly visible between supporter group and the team, Shannon, Alex, everything that happened in the background, what we've heard on that as well. Just it's heartwarming to have that be the result of it after such an event. Anyway, cool. Thank you for that. But yeah, moving on into what's happening now, and you know, Wave haven't been at Snapdragon in a while. So what's coming up in terms of San Diego Wave support with the Sirens, with the I guess Louisville game coming up? Is there any watch parties, do you know?
We will be having a watch party. An announcement is coming tomorrow. So stay tuned on our socials. We're going to officially announce. We're going to have an open chant and drum practice this weekend before the watch party on Saturday. And then in response to like everything that happened with our banners, we're going to have like an art banner session the following weekend. It inspired Troy, and he like came up with art instantly. So there'll be some new artwork going up on the Cove. So it's just going to be an awesome way for us to connect with the community a little bit more, and for there to be more connections to the Cove, more personal connections. So we're excited for that.
And speaking of community, right, this is something that is a large part of what happens and why it's a beloved movement. San Diego Sirens were out there for Chicano Federation's Dia de los Niños celebration. Chicano Fed with hundreds of kiddos and their families that were able to receive books, toys, foods, diapers, yeah, and other household essentials. Just, you know, getting out there representing for the team, for the Sirens. A great cause, great mobilization. What was that like? As we see, wow, that's pretty impressive.
It was a lot of work, but there were so many of us that we knocked it out super fast. Most of our Siren team was downstairs checking the people in, the families and the kids as they came in, and then we'd send them up. So it was just awesome to see the soccer community kind of come together and support the Chicano Federation. Dia de los Niños is personally something important to me. So it was awesome to just have like my Siren family there with me too. Chicano Federation does amazing work in the community too. So it was just perfect.
And you guys have been going out in the community, enjoying other teams too, the Mojo and just the activations that happen there. Like, it's really cool seeing this interweb of just culture coming up and being shrouded about because of soccer and the game. Sorry,
I got you off. I know the Sirens also have a little project coming up, right, with the podcast.
Episode four,
yeah, on the works.
Yeah, we do have episode four. Actually, before I came on here, I was with Sarah recording some stuff.
That's awesome. How's that going?
I give you guys props. It's a lot of work. It's not as easy as it sounds. I think I was talking to Tony for a little bit about sound and ways and programs that you can try to amplify audio and stuff like that. And I totally forgot to give back to you, Tony.
You're good.
No worries.
It's all good. Like,
anything we can help with, let us know.
Yeah, I mean, and it's part of it, and we're here, and we can support it in many ways, and even if you don't, that's A-okay. Don't worry, I don't take it personal. but no, I really truly believe in this organic movement, and I want to give you know, as much of a platform as we possibly can, and highlight, you know, events and activities and motions that the Sirens are doing themselves. So keep doing it. Honestly, that's the one thing. You know, we've been doing 219 weeks in a row. So I would hope that it got a little better since day one. So it'll click. It's everything's gonna come together, and it's good. I like the conversations that are being had. It's a really good perspective, because that's how I get perspective on what's going on, and the ins and outs of you know, we see their positions, we know who they are, the Sirens, we see them out at the Cove, but it gives a little bit more of an insight of the personality. So keep it going, 100%. Looking forward to coming back at home, so A lot of people that are, you know, just kind of.
Any big plans for the next home game? April 27th.
I think there are some things going on, but they haven't been finalized, so I can't give too much away.
I like it. We wouldn't be doing our job.
Just know, everyone, there's something coming up.
We wouldn't be doing our job if we didn't ask to begin with. So
ask the hard questions.
Absolutely. So when can people look for potentially an episode 4 and anything else happening with the Sirens or yourself?
Potentially as soon as tomorrow. It's an episode that I personally really, really love. And I'm going to tell you right now, I cried on it. Was just a great emotional conversation that was had. And I can't wait for everyone else to hear it.
Absolutely. So once that drops on socials, let us know. We'll amplify that too, just to make sure that we have as many ears on that. So congratulations. Keep it going. And it's part of it. It's part of it. And people will tune in for that. So Tanya, anything else before we let you go today?
Just come out to the watch parties. Come out to the event. Paint session is going to be fun. Drop session is going to be fun. And let's just have fun together.
That's what it's all about. Tanya, thank you for your time. We'll catch you here soon again. I love this segment for the same reason. We get the insight directly from the Sirens themselves. Thank you for coming on, Tanya. Have a good night.
Absolutely. Thank you guys for having me.
No worries. Have a good one. Shout
out to the Sirens.
Great work. I mean, look, we try to highlight the positives that always are happening. And so far, right now it's tough, right? Because there's no actual San Diego Wave games. But same thing with Loyal was here, or even SDFC. Like SDFC, they're doing their Chrome Ball tour. They're doing their philanthropic everything. But right now, in season for the Wave, they can actually do some dynamic things. And sometimes they are tied because of the games where a lot of players would want to come out to the community, can't. But I know that through the team itself, they are looking into expanding in ways like that. So thank you again, Tanya, from the Sirens. Call the Sirens. Bi-weekly check-in. And check out the Siren Show. I know that, you know, probably it's going to, as she said, Tanya said, it's going to be an emotional episode. So I'm intrigued. Check it out on their socials and sign up for the membership. Do it. There's a free one. Shout out to everybody as well. I know we're mentioning the San Diego Soccer's game. But I think it's commendable. And I want to shout out SDFC for sponsoring, San Diego FC for sponsoring a happy hour for the supporters to go go watch De Los Pedos and do a ruckus and do great things in Section 19 for the sports arena.
And they also did a Voice of the Community with Phil.
The Voice of the Community package is a really cool vignette that's on their website. So check that out. Walking the Walk. So shout out to them. The Riptides also getting involved. The locals having a synergetic little relationship with the Sirens and the Cove is really cool to see. Black Speech, this mother is the way you like. I love the fact that there's just different expressions of supporters with San Diego Wave,
and that just defines what San Diego is. Very diverse.
Yeah, dude, it's so
like, it's so many diverse supporters at this point that
and
the thing is, it's within some of the same people, which everyone has different personalities, and it's amazing to see.
The Sirens have done their work. They're established. They're the A side. But again, it's like, it's really fun to see different faces, similar faces, familiar faces, but different places.
And before we dive into MLS and the Chrome Ball Tour, absolutely. San Diego Wave, they do have the game. I know last week we mentioned, you know what, we'll talk about the next game in the next episode since it'll be in that week. They're facing Louisville, and it's a Taylor Flint, Horniak.
Is it official? Game. Is that, I mean, 100%, but like, does the jersey still say?
The jersey says Flint. So Taylor Flint.
Congratulations, Taylor.
So it's a revenge game. As we heard from Casey Stoney herself in an interview earlier this year.
With San Diego Punto Futbol.
With San Diego Punto Futbol.
Check it out.
With Casey Stoney, just she doesn't want a player that's not willing to compete. Speaking about Horniak, and therefore having McCaskill now on the team. So Horniak got shipped to Louisville in a trade where she wanted to just be a starter for sure.
Mm-hmm.
And they're not having the best record.
Yeah, no. So they're 0-3, two away matches, one at home. So three losses there. You know, it's very difficult to just even talk about. Well, comparatively, where San Diego Wave has played one less game altogether because of the Challenge Cup in the beginning of the year with Gotham. So essentially, it's a 2-1 just this season, but not in this tournament.
I mean, it's three ties, not three defeats.
Ties, excuse me.
Yeah. I mean, soccer, the middle column is the losses in the
world. Sometimes my Americanization, it's happened. It's for some first game you can watch. I love that. So it's gonna be an interesting matchup. So with that, we can kind of overlap a little bit of the, you know, She Believes Cup with, you know, Naomi Girma.
Yeah, exactly. Is she gonna play?
Naomi Girma got injured not this game, but last game.
She was in the bench and in the final of the She Believes Cup with the U.S. against the Canadian women's national team. So she's there. She can play. She's maybe not 100%, but I have a feeling she could start. I don't know if Casey Stoney will just kind of give this chance to Sarah Enge to be in the center back position as a starter along with Dahlkemper, but if the national team players are not good to travel and they don't get to participate, who do you put at center back? You got Sierra Angie. Who else?
It gets kind of dicey, or you have to work with your formation a little bit differently. But overall, it's good to see Naomi Girma on the bench because she's fit enough to come in for a short burst. But I do know that if you're Casey Stoney, you're kind of holding your breath and hoping that she's going to be match fit by the time you have to have her facing Louisville, because again, it's going to be a team that's going to be coming in and rallying around Korniak. She knows exactly why she left. She knows that her time in San Diego wasn't necessarily the best towards the end, especially, but it'll be an interesting matchup. They'll be away. This is going to be
on Saturday, the game.
On Saturday, so that check out the Sirens watch party if you want to go ahead and have a good time over there. But yeah, so we have a couple of San Diego Wave players who are on international break. Obviously, the ones that just played today, Kaylin Sheridan. You have Jaden Shaw. Dahlkemper got called up. Morgan, obviously, but also you have Emily Van Egmond getting called up. Essentially, all the internationals.
Yeah,
we're gone.
It's 10 players.
Kira getting the start today. Carusa with the Irish national team.
Yeah, this game's going to be Saturday at 4:30 p.m. Pacific Standard Time.
Mm-hmm.
Check that out. There's going to be watch parties. I believe Wave announced they're doing one of the watch parties as well, so I don't know if the Sirens will be tagging along in that or having their own, but it's going to be an interesting game. It's definitely one to watch. It's definitely one that maybe Taylor Flint has marked in her calendar for sure.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's the same way for some players. Maybe they didn't have the best relationship. From what we've seen, all the players are always friends.
Yeah, they're friends.
There's never that rivalry.
I do want to see that.
I do want to see that.
I want them to just hate each other. Like,
yeah, I don't like it. I want to see that for sure.
San Diego Wave introduced the 2024 Pub Partners, Pure Project Balboa, Fair Play, and Novo Brasil Brewery. And I think that's the Mission Valley one specifically. So that's going to be there. Hopefully the Sirens can link up with that or just make a partnership to get the most people out there at once. This also led to Jaden Shaw playing tonight against Canada and Kaylin Sheridan. Jaden Shaw getting the best of Kaylin Sheridan tonight, getting having some fantastic play. She's doing really amazingly. It's continuing a tear through every place that she stops and plays.
Yeah, she didn't get to score today, but I mean, she scored in every single one of her other starts. So, shout out to Jaden Shaw scoring in the semifinal technically against Japan, and then going into this final and starting again against Canada. But yeah, there were three different Wave players that started with Dahlkemper in the starting lineup, Jaden Shaw and Alex Morgan. So in the semifinal, it was Naomi Girma, Jaden Shaw, and Alex Morgan starting. So kind of like Dahlkemper and Naomi Girma seem to be the replacements of one another. When it comes to the women's national team. So will we ever get to see the pair in the women's national team? Hopefully. That'd be pretty cool.
I don't know. I don't know how long this was. But Somebody commented on Instagram, where the fuck is loyal on the wall? Is it why or where? Where's there?
No, where?
Why is
they're not because a team
they
anymore?
Were a team and it's cool. Like, it's retro now. Like, interesting. Interesting.
That was cool.
Sign him. Hello.
Oh,
for SDFC.
Him for SD. Oh, probably talking about.
Talking about me?
No, not you.
Oh, thank you, Cabana Elijah
boy
Martin.
Jeff. Cabana boy Jeff.
Tony didn't warm up. Yeah, no, we have people coming in. They had ringers. I mean, going back again, we can.
I love that Frecker's watching from everywhere, from YouTube, from Instagram.
He's a supporter, man.
And, yeah.
Again, we appreciate everybody who supports. Abraham Cepeda, our great writer, is going to be coming up with an article. International flair on San Diego Punto Football. He's been doing absolute bits as well.
Heck yeah.
So shout out to everybody who's involved in San Diego Punto Football. That is the website, the name of the game. San Diego Punto Football.
Who do you have winning this game? You going Wave? You going
I
tie?
Think San Diego Wave is gonna win. I think they're in a good spot. The players are in form. Yeah, even if they're not.
I think Wave have a pretty easy win. I think they win like 3-0, 3-1.
I think so. I think it's a good time to show that their position, and hopefully it's not a situation where they play down.
On the
to
other
the competition.
Hand, I would love if Taylor Flint just scores a hat trick.
A hat trick in a 3-3. Sure, let's go. Wow, like I'm okay
cool
with that.
Too. That'd be pretty cool.
Three by McCaskill. Yeah, that'd be great.
Ugaya?
Oh, McCaskill red card on Taylor. Oh. Juego limpio, yeah. Fair play, please.
San Diego Wave, big shout out. Good luck if they watch that stuff.
Waving at San Diego Wave, interesting maneuver. All right, so moving over, switching gears to San Diego FC, SDFC. Still don't have a game scheduled, but again, they've been involved in various different things. There was I think we talked about it last time, a Right to Dream. Had a Q&A session just kind of talking about some emerging talent in the scout department for them, how it's going to be put together. We've discussed how much we think that it's really going to influence the team, and it's going to be a basis of academy players. That's why we don't think that when people like David Feitelson decide to speculate that San Diego's own Hugo Sanchez is going to be named the head coach. Look, if it happens, it happens. I'm like, sure, it's going to. And clearly, I would hope the ESPN guy has better intel than we do. But at the same time.
No, I, and honestly, that was a clout tweet. That was a tweet for clout. Because he brought that up again. He's done it before. He's done it multiple times in his career, just tweeting something for clout. You know, fight the signs for left ESPN, went with Univision. At the end of the day, sometimes you need more traction on Twitter, and that's exactly what he did with that tweet. He got great traction. It was definitely clout. I don't think Hugo Sanchez is going to be the head coach for SDFC. It just makes no sense. When's the last time he was the head coach? Already proven to not be a great head coach.
And it had a good discussion. So, this is information from San Diego. El nuevo club de la MLS para el 2025. The new MLS club for 2025, El San Diego FC, the property of Egyptian-English Sir Mohamed Mansour y del pelotero de los padres. So he decides to, you know, obviously put the biggest two names of Mansour and Manny Machado.
Probably has no idea. This.
No
this
idea.
Siquan
he has no idea owns. Who Siquan is. No, yeah. Nothing.
Again, clout chasing.
And they're thinking, están pensando en esta combinación. They're thinking about this combination. Hugo Sanchez as a coach. And Guillermo Ochoa as the first captain, not even first player, the first captain. What do you think? ¿Qué les parece? Garbage, trash. Like, yeah. It makes absolutely no sense. What?
Oh, there's like flashing lights outside. I don't know. That was a car leaving, probably.
Okay. Hopefully not my car because I have the keys. But yeah, so SDFC, I don't think would make this move at all. You know, we did report about Guillermo Ochoa in talks with SDFC, and I think it would be an interesting.
Just to be safe.
I hate you for that. For those who are listening, he clicked his alarm.
Just to be safe.
Okay, you can do that later. But yeah, we reported that Guillermo Ochoa might be coming in here as well. There are some leads into that. But this Hugo Sanchez thing is just a reach. You know, there were people in the comments that were saying like, oh, it makes sense. You know, he was a reverend of the San Diego Soccer's Hugo Sanchez. And I clearly replied, at no moment was he an important player for San Diego Soccer's. Like, yeah, he was good. He was all right here. But like, his name isn't in the rafters. Like,
yeah, no,
like
no.
It's not that type of situation. But yeah, I don't think that'd be a winning combination in any sense.
Honestly, some people are saying, oof, that'd be great, except for Hugo Sanchez.
I could see that. I mean,
I don't even think people are hyped for Hugo Sanchez. I think a lot of people are hyped to bring Memo Ochoa. And why wouldn't you? It's San Memo, right? But as those who actually follow the game and Memo Ochoa and club career, he's not the best. Not when it comes to club.
There is some sources that have told me that it does seem that Miguel Herrera has been sending feelers out into the potential of jumping over to SDFC. Miguel Herrera, Super Saiyajin, Mexico DT. Right now he's in Cholos, having the worst season of his career.
In his last press conference, just said he's already planning for next year for Cholos.
So yeah, he's planning on it. That honestly has more capacity to be true than Hugo Sanchez, just because there are just things in the air. But again, that's one side. Like I can say I'm putting feelers out there to coach SDFC. So here we go. In breaking news, Tony Sanchez has postulated himself in order to be considered for the captaincy and the coach job. So not just one, but two. So there you go. As much
check out the highlights.
Yeah, 100%. Check out the highlights. I'm a leader. 3-0. I'm undefeated at Snapdragon.
If you did not get a contract for San Diego Loyal, you will not be getting one for San Diego FC. Sorry.
Les llegó la policía, says Tanya. Honestly, I've had that. So fun fact. Have I ever told you this? The day I tore my ACL. I was in pain. I had to drive myself from National City to Imperial Beach on a stick shift with a torn ACL. It's not fun because it was my left foot. I couldn't put the clutch. I went in first gear. Anyway, go to TJ, get it checked out. They're like, yep, you're fucked. So here's some meds. Here's some pills. Come back tomorrow. We'll evaluate and probably do a surgery. Great. So I come back and I'm in my back room. My room is separated from the actual main house. And so we come over and I'm like, cool, I'm gonna take my meds. Feel great. Like, I just feel great. I took some vitamins. And you know, the evidence of the vitamins are just in my room. Cause I'm zonked out. Like, this was 12 years ago. And out of nowhere, like, again, just like you said, flashing lights. And this has something to do with it. Flashing lights around my room. I'm like, what? That makes no sense. I hear wrangling. I open my door and the screen door still closed, and through it I see flashlights. I open that door and I'm all just like, here's the pain pills and just the other. It's just, there's a canine and two cops pointing a gun and a flashlight at me. And they're like, who else is in there? Who else is in there? Get out. I have a tourney. I'm working with crutches, and I'm like, it's just me. I'm like, okay, cool. Like, hobble out. They go in, check everything. I'm like, uh-oh, you know, I got vitamin stuff in there. And so that doesn't happen. My parents are looking now like, oh, what's going on? ¿Qué pasó? Long story short, it was a high-speed chase that they were looking for a guy, and they saw the guy running in this vicinity. And so what ends up happening is that I go into my living room, and then like 10 SDPD cops walk from my backyard through my house outside, and they just leave because the guy wasn't there. So as they're leaving, again, flashing lights, everybody's leaving, I'm like, it's a summer and it's hot, and we always left a window open.
Gotcha.
And I was like, again, I'm all zonked out. I'm just like, I left that window open. I didn't close it. And I always leave that door closed, open, unlocked.
And it's
locked. You should check. And I told the last cop, and he was like, okay. As they're all walking, the last guy checks the door, and it's locked. And I'm like,
he's in there.
So they opened the garage door, and the guy was in my garage hiding after a high-speed chase. He left the sweater on the little corralito, and he came in here. He closed the window, turned off the lights, and it was just crouched there. The only one that knew that they were there was my dog inside, who kept scratching into the garage. Like, and we were like, okay, you know, the cops are here. She's getting all like,
oh,
but
man.
Like, they knew that it was there. But flashing lights, tangent. Thank you, Tanya, for that. All right. So SDFC, obviously we need to keep an eye on the MLS. We're going to go ahead and do an MLS wrap up. We're going to go ahead and call some experts, see if they can go ahead and join us and just help us navigate what's going to be incoming. But we also have a segment that looks at the sibling teams of STFC through the Rights to Dream Project, mm-hmm. in Marcos Invartsen. Marcos Invartsen getting himself another goal. I believe you sent that to me, correct?
Right, I believe here. I did.
So we're going
to beating Copenhagen.
Copenhagen, Champions League glory team. Courtesy of Euro Football, the corner, a whipping corner.
That's not it. It's
but again, that's a goal. Impressive. It's here. Right? Right there.
Yeah, they're celebrating that.
That's the first great goal. Second goal here. Marcus Invartsen, after a scramble inside the box, just laces it through with his left foot, controlling in traffic. It's a difficult shot to make. But you know,
that ended up winning this game 2-1. So shout out Invartsen, that's San Diego FC's future striker. Also plays as a center attacking mid. So big shout out. What?
Shout out. I'm just having empathy for a torn ACL and just a messed up knee in a situation. It was one of the weirdest days. It was one of the weirdest days of my life.
Bet, dude, that's a great story, though.
Yeah.
That's a great story.
No, I think. How can I do this?
It was in the news?
No, I have a picture, actually. From.
That you posted?
I'll get to it later. Yeah, no, I posted it on Instagram, on my personal Instagram, so. Years ago, it's just like it's the picture of them opening the garage and pointing the guns into the garage. It was pretty cool. I shouldn't have been anywhere near that situation, but you know, here I am. All right, cool. Moving into El Juego Bonito, the last segment that we have for today. Unless we have anything else, thank you guys for sticking around. Everybody's favorite segment so far this season of Two Balls and a Mic.
No, I'm just very hyped. Sorry to cut you off. Yeah, I'm just very excited for the Chrome Ball Tour in Chula Vista. Sounds like it's going to be a big one. Chula Vista Police Department against the Chula Vista Fire Department. Mm-hmm. So that's going to be a fun match to watch. And then a 3v3 tournament. They're going to have Lucha Libre coming out. They're going to have performances. They're closing off 3rd Avenue.
It's pretty much
a block party in Chula Vista. I'm glad that it's on 3rd Avenue. They're doing it right. I'm excited to see how it goes. What's up?
It's just a little Rob, man. Like,
hey, man,
you guys should have saved him for National City. Like,
this is going to be the biggest Chrome Ball Tour.
100%.
Chula Vista 100%. Is going to be the biggest Chrome Ball Tour they're putting together. But, so they're putting you think of South Bay, you think Chula Vista.
But when it's summer days, just sitting around, and then when the sun goes down, he'll be ready to party. Oh, hey, he's living it up in summer nights in National City. He's driving through Highland and Plaza Avenue. You can see the old.
Yeah, but like, I mean, he's performing in Chula Vista. Sorry, man.
Along with Rossi Rock. Smooth like I'm in. Yeah, it's an excellent song. And Sebi OG. We'll have hopefully a representative from SDFC come on and just let's get a roundup of how these are going and what it's been looking like on their end. They're collecting data, they're learning, they're really getting into the weeds of things. So good on SDFC for doing it right. Really going into it here in the South Bay. So shout out to them for the Chrome Ball Tour. They did reschedule the Carlsbad one over into August. So
yeah,
stay tuned for that. All right. Anything else, Shiba? Juego Bonito time.
Juego Bonito.
It is everybody's favorite segment. Juego Bonito. Goals, gaffes, and great. Good ones for today. We're going to go ahead and start with goals. Goals. We'll start from the top. So Jaden Shaw, San Diego Wave FC player. A banger against Japan.
It's just the vision she has. She knows where to place the ball. She knows how to shoot it. We've seen this happen many times for Jaden Shaw. So she's still doing what she does at all levels with every team. Shout out to Jaden Shaw winning another goal of the week.
I'm going to ask her just like I asked Joe Corona. Hey Jaden Shaw, you're a two-time goal of the week winner for San Diego Punto Football. How does that make you feel?
Huh? I'm sorry, what?
What are you talking about?
What?
Shout out.
I feel like she'd be nice and she'd be like, oh
thank you.
That's great.
That's great.
That's awesome. What is that?
Oh, it's you guys? Oh, cool.
We also had another one.
We did have a second goal of the week. This courtesy of us. UPSL SoCal South Action, the reigning, defending, once upon a time champions of the division, your girlfriend's favorite soccer team, SD Internacional, trouncing Inland Empire 4-0 in this last Saturday's match.
It's hard to come into the UPSL as a new team and win a East Lake Soccer League.
It was impressive. Inspired Ernie.
But uno, dos, tres.
Anything Ernie touches turns to gold, and it's still gold right now.
Cuatro.
Kev, Cinco. Good play. Listeners just think you're counting slowly.
No Brasileiro Neto.
Pass into the middle. Good tiki-taka. Good build-up play for SC Inter with the shoulder. It's got another fantastic play.
Nine passes.
Goal!
Like little tiki-taka that setting it with the chest. Super smart. Great finish there. And I mean, SD Inter shout out with another goal of the week.
Golazo. Golazo. So those are our two goals of the week. If you have goals of the week that you want to send your cousins, your primas, primos, if you scored it, send it over. It can potentially win against some of these other great local goals, which now brings us to the gaffe of the week. And this, the gaffe and the great come from the same place, same day, same vicinity of time.
Same universe.
But let me set the stage, right? So San Diego Soccers are winning. The Texas team is getting frustrated. Their goalkeeper had a legendary performance the day before. He lost his head, started yapping, got himself yellow card.
And now this is happening in the mini game, right?
So it happened in the 15-minute game, and that's it. There's only no quarters, just 15 minutes. A yellow card means 5 minutes that you are out and you can't contribute to your team. So that happened in a crucial moment for this stellar goalkeeper. Lost his head, goes into the sin bin, just like hockey. And then when it's time to come out, one of the craziest things, and he actually did it once at some point, but in this situation, it's just, I don't like what I saw.
Return leg. That will be April 21st.
So right here,
this coming weekend,
he's coming in the red in a bit here from the bottom middle right, where you see the center line. He is already out, and he's already at the top of the benches right here, actually. And he already said hi and bye to the soccer's bench, walked by his bench, didn't say anything to anybody, and the goalkeeper just starts walking out, saying bye to everybody. There's still time. Yeah, sure, you're losing 4-0, but he's legitimately walking out of this match on his team, not staying in the bench, just saying he's done. From what we heard, he told Boris that he quit. He quit.
Bench.
That's it. He quit
his own on his way out.
That is insane.
Enjoyed
confusion everywhere. Run. What's going on? Smiles like, what? Top did that just happen?
I have no idea what that was about.
Craig, he left. He quit. That was what that was about. Walking out on your team.
That is crazy.
Is going to earn you a gaffe of the week.
100%. That is crazy. Pollito. Pinche quit there.
Che gallinita, güey. Like, that's not okay.
Pollito.
Pio, pio. Cool. So, leading us to the great. And this can only be one person. One person.
Rightfully so. Rightfully so.
It stands to the test of time. Cabana Boy Jeff. The greatest
Another
player.
Legendary performance.
The greatest player in the San Diego Soccer's media game. Two hat tricks. He was one. One of the goals. That was. Just hang his name in the rafters already. Yeah. Like hang it up there. Like I just
scored specimen. The tying goal last year. But
he did
after the buzzer. So allegedly.
And you know what? He learned his lesson. Now he's on my team. It's back to his winning ways. But yeah, that's the way to do it. Yep, that is the way to do it. San Diego
Cabana Boy Jeff
FC's great of the week, and that has been. When it the goals, gaps, and greats. All right, Chiva. Well, I think we had a good episode today. I think we so fixed too. It. I think everything went well. I'm not going to see you for 3 days. I'm getting flown for work purposes to Houston on a United airline. I mean, that's very insensitive if you were going where I think you were going.
No, you're flying.
Oh, it's just turbulence. Got it. Yeah. Hey.
Hey, qué pedo?
Hey, dude. That's not okay. I can't believe. Wow.
No hice nada.
You didn't get out of the way.
Of what?
Try it again.
No. Okay. Have fun in Texas. Live it up. Ponte bien pedo. Ponte hasta la madre.
It's a work
enjoy,
thing.
Enjoy the Texas life.
People have been asking.
Have
me,
some barbecue. Have some Whataburger.
I'm there to work. I will have barbecue. I will have Whataburger. I will have a full report. When we come back, In-N-Out versus Whataburger. I might just go get In-N-Out as a baseline right now. Like, literally the last thing from California will be good. Jeff Field does not melt. He'll be said el toro fuerte. We'll see. The reports will come out eventually.
Have fun, man.
I will try to have fun. So with that, it is time to end another fantastic episode. Two balls. End of mic. Brought to you in part by PB European Imports. Smog Express, if you need to get your car checked or fixed, PB European Imports
is the way to go.
Ask for Coach Alex and Zurdo over at Smog Express.
And then Tony and Chiva sent you.
Don't expect less. Smog Express.
Wow. All right.
In Pacific Beach. Ask for Zurdo, Coach Alex. Thank you for everybody who joined today. Really appreciate everybody in the chat, everybody who supports us, everybody who gives us the opportunity to make asses of ourselves in a celebrity game, a halftime media match. It's truly an honor. It's crazy. Go check out the Soccers. Go plant a tree. I don't know. Figure yourself out.
Do something. All right.
Bye.
Have a good one, everybody.